Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Tonight, Father Jovito Parungay, the pastor of Ascension Parish in Elmhurst, who is celebrating our annual Mass in honor of St. Lawrence Ruiz and the Filipino martyrs, organized by our parish Filipino committee. So we're very happy to have the Apostolic Choir with us today, and we thank them for providing us with song sheets. And I hope you will join in as they lead us in prayer and Father prays for us at the altar through the intercession of all the Filipino saints and martyrs.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, "There was a rich man who received purple garments and fine linen, and tied sumptuously sleeve each day. And lying at his door was a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who would gladly have eaten his fill of the sprouts that fell from the rich man's table. Dogs even used to come and lick his sores. When the poor man died, he was carried away by angels to the bosom of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried, and of the nether world where he was in torment, he raised his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. And he cried out, 'Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and hold my tongue, for I am suffering torment in his flames.' Abraham replied, 'My child, remember that you received what was good during your lifetime, while Lazarus likewise received what was bad. But now he is comforted here, whereas you are tormented. Moreover, between us and you, a great chasm is established to prevent anyone from crossing who might wish to go from our side to yours, or from your side to ours.' He said, 'Then I bid you, Father, send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, so that he may warn them, lest he too come to this place of torment.' But Abraham replied, 'They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.' He said, 'Oh no, Father Abraham, but if someone of the dead goes to them, they will repent.' Then Abraham said, 'If they will not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded if someone should raise from the dead.'" My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord. So good of the Lord. So first of all, I would like to thank Monsignor Chen for welcoming our first Filipino Senate and of course the deputies of San Lorenzo Ruiz or St. Lawrence Ruiz. There was a rich man who went to see a psychiatrist. Why? Because he had symptoms of depression. He confided that years ago he had many friends. Now that he has become rich, he has no more friends. So the doctor led him to the glass window and asked, "What do you see through this window?" "I see some people on the street," the man said. Then the doctor led him in front of the mirror. "Now, tell me, what do you see?" The man replied, "I see my own face." "That's right," the doctor exclaimed. "You see, the window and the mirror are both made of glass. When you looked through the window, you saw other people. But isn't it interesting that with a little amount of silver tinted at the back of the glass of the mirror, you saw only yourself? But the brothers and sisters, Blessed Pope John Paul II said, the great danger for family life in the midst of any society whose idols are pressure, comfort and independence lies in the fact that people close their hearts and become selfish. The point is, every time money and selfishness rule our lives, we willfully close our eyes to the plight of our brothers and sisters in need, to the plight of our neighbors. And this leads to problems and troubles in our society. Not long ago, my dear brothers and sisters, the world was divided vertically, east and west, between the Oriental and Western civilizations in opposition. That will do what we want to do. So sin commission is not just a matter of simple negligence by their friends or oversight. It is very serious sin because it is rooted in selfishness and wanton disregard for others. It is rooted in selfishness. So the theme of the parable this Sunday bears a striking similarity with that of the Last Judgment in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 25. In both accounts, the condemnation is not based on the wrong done, but on the good deed not done. Not on the sin of omission, but on the sin of omission. Jesus said, I was hungry, and you did not give me food. I was thirsty, and you did not give me drink. I was naked, you did not clothe me. In prison, unseen, but you did not visit me. So I remember a story about a certain family who invited some people to dinner. So at the table, the mother asked her 4-year-old son, Tommy, would you please lead us in prayer before we eat? Of course, the boy was surprised, but Mom, I did not know what to say, he protested. Just say what you hear, Mommy, the mother replied. Then the boy bowed his head and said, Lord, why on this earth did I invite all these people to dinner? Is that selfish? Like what happened to this guy? You know him? This guy is a very simple, a family man with kids, but selfishness is not one of his work in his vocabulary, but faithfulness. Faithfulness instead of selfishness that will lead that's the one why he is happier. Faithfulness in the face of death. That's why he was given to give his life. If Lorenzo is selfish, he can denounce his faith in God just to save his life. But no, he remained faithful and strong in his faith in God. And he said, if I had 1,000 lives, I will offer it in Jukan, because I am a Christian and I believe in Jesus Christ. I am not many brothers and sisters, that the example of this simple guy will help us also to see not only ourselves, but to see other people, most especially in their needs. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
For the United States of America, the country we consider our second home, that the Lord may protect this country and its people from violence and acts of terrorism, and it may continue to lead other nations in the pursuit of freedom and respect for the dignity of human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive. Amen.